What? Right.
What's up, guys? Myself, Williams, aka TheSwolefessor, here to get you on health and social well-being. We're 2 weeks out, baby. 2 weeks, that's 14 days, and including the day, 10 more training sessions until we step up on the platform, USAPL Raw National 2019. And I'm super excited. You guys just saw me work up to my top set of a single at RP6, and it felt great. Like, usually, especially the past couple blocks, my week ones don't feel amazing because I'm still recovering from the fatigue of the final week from the previous block, but with each block, I've just acclimated more and more and more. Like, that was a very, very smooth 452 for my RP6. And at this point, everything's about just being true, executing perfectly, and building into Raw Nationals. Because next week will be like, for this day, RP 7.5s, and then boom, we go all out on meet day. And I'm feeling really, really good. I'm trying to be as on point with everything as possible. I've got Michael, you know, watching my depth from the side, giving me commands, and you know, we're just trying to be on top of every single variable. Not gonna be cramping today. Brought plenty of food, brought me some bagels on top of my water, my Gatorade, got my triorals, got my levels pre-workout. Like, we're on top of every little thing today, and it's feeling really, really good. So we also have an RP6 on deadlifts, an RP7 on bench, so I'm gonna get through the back down work on squats, then go on with the rest of the workout. Oh, one more thing, you guys may have noticed that my shoes look a little bit different today. These are still L Runs, all black, because you know your boys kind of swag sled a little bit, not even gonna lie. But I ended up ordering another pair. I told you guys in my previous video where I was reviewing the L Runs and comparing them to the A6 wrestling shoes and comparing them to the Notorious lift slippers, that if you get the L Runs, you want to go down like a size. So I wear a size 9 in normal shoes, so I went to a size 8 for my original L Runs, and that still holds true for the vast majority of you. But if you're someone like me where you kind of have a slightly more narrow foot, or you just want your shoe to fit a little bit more snug, because I'm so used to how the A6 feel as far as snugness, that's the only thing that felt kind of off with squatting the L Run. So if that's you and you have a narrow foot, or you just want your shoes to be a little bit more snug, go down a size and a half, because these are 7.5s and they fit perfectly. They feel just as snug as the A6, but they have all the benefits of course, the L Runs being like, you know, flatter, better grip, can really feel the ground. Everything just feels amazing. But anyway, yeah, let's get this back down to work, man.
Get him, Marcellus. Come on. Come
on. Let's go finish. There we go. Come on.
Come on. Let's go get it up. Yep.
Come on. Come on.
Good.
Woo. There was a little bit of a... Yeah, guys. So back down sets are done. That's 5x5. With 4 to 7 pounds, you guys saw my first set and my last set, and man, that last set did not feel great. But like I said, this is the highest volume week leading up into the meet, and everything felt really good. Like, the last time I felt this kind of gas from back down sets was when I did 396 for a 5x5. Not the last time I did it, that felt pretty good, but the very first time I did it. So I'm really happy with just like how my body's been acclimating everything. Now, the heaviest I've done for back down sets is a 3x3 with 430 last week, but this is the most as far as just total workload being done. So we're in a really, really good spot. To be able to do something like that without feeling like complete trash, like, I was laid out the first time I did 396 for a 5x5. So to do essentially like 10 more pounds than that for a 5x5, 2 weeks out, is huge, because once I get through this highest workload week and then taper going to meet, we're gonna be good to go. And Michael's over here killing it as well. So he's got, I think, a couple more back down sets and we're gonna get to pulls.
Yeah, I mean, honestly. It's rate of perceived exertion.
Perceived, right? You know what I think you need to adjust is the setup. It wasn't quite, you know, it wasn't quite centric enough. You got it.
You're right. And then just rip it off the floor.
You didn't do any dance before you set up,
right? You got to do the summoning jutsu.
You got to do the spirit fingers.
The spirit fingers. You got to be like this, man. You got to be like.
You got to do the Macarena. You got to do the. You gotta move your hips. and then you gotta.
Alright guys, pulls are feeling really good from the warm-ups. What I'm working on is trying to like aggressively wedge into the pull, but then ramp up my tension. Rather than just do one big hip shoot where I try to like go at it full force and risk losing position, I'm still wedging into it hard, but not with as big of a hip shoot so that I can just ramp up the tension. So we're gonna keep that going and see how it feels. Alright guys, so top set of deadlifts felt fantastic. Like, my last warm-up felt really, really good as far as, like I said, just getting in position and ramping the tension up. The only thing I changed on my top set was just externally rotating my shoulders a little bit. Boom. Y'all didn't see that. Nah, externally rotating my shoulders a little bit more, getting the back a little bit tighter so I could stay in better position all the way through, and it felt good. Like, that moved so much better than 529 did on this day of this week. Last block, like that was a perfect good true six for me, so we're good to go, about to get these back downs. But yeah, like to get break it down a little bit more, I think what it is for me guys is that if I just try to rush down to the bar, right, one, I'm not starting in as good a position, and if I try to get to that good position by like just pulling all the slack out and hip shooting and wedging right into it, it just doesn't feel as stable. That's why you guys often will see me like hip shoot really hard, but then I'll come up a little bit and then it'll come up, whereas with this, if I just get the slack out and then just ramp into it and build the tension up while keeping everything else as tight as possible, it's so much smoother. It doesn't come off the ground quite as quickly, but positioning matters way more than speed off the ground when it comes to the sumo. Really, I believe that for deadlifting in general, like even conventional pullers, yes, usually conventional is faster off the ground than sumo, but the reality is if you're getting it off the ground really fast, but you're extra rounded, even though it's easier to grind through that on conventional than sumo, that still puts you in a suboptimal position for locking it out. Whereas if you stay tight and it comes off the ground a little bit slower, whether conventional or sumo, but you're keeping that back tight, your lockout's gonna be a lot cleaner. So definitely feel a lot better as far as that. Like I said, from this moment going forward, because I started this last week on my back downs and then my secondary day pulls, I'm just using straps because it keeps my hook grip feeling much, much fresher for like my top singles. Like I said, I believe if you first start hook gripping, you should be hook gripping everything just to get it down, get comfortable, get used to it. But now that I'm at that point, there's no need to like just over fatigue my grip, because that's the point I was getting to. So yeah, knock out these back downs, then get to bench.
Here it is, come on. Good, yes. Nice.
Alright guys, so bench warm-ups are feeling absolutely fantastic right now. At this point, Michael's gone because he just squats the deadlifts on this day and he has work on this day. So he's gone. So since I don't have someone to actually give him the press command, I'm just really making sure that my pauses are clean, competition pauses, and then just pressing off with everything I got.
yeah.
So I am extremely happy with that top set. Like, this is what I hit for my RP7 last block, but on week two, because last block I had RP7 week one, and then another RP7 week two. I think week one I hit 325, and then I felt better the following week, hit 330. So to hit 330 today at RP7, especially when I'm used to taking liftoffs with this heavy a load, just so I can stay in better position, and I feel like the pause was clean, everything was good, man. Like everything, as far as my top sets, is so much better than this point on last block. Like I hit 452 last block as well, but it was so much smoother. I hit 529 like I did for deadlifts last block, moved so much smoother, and then 5 more pounds than what I did week one of last block, and it moved amazingly. So I'm in a very, very good spot right now. Now I've got, just like some of the squats, 5 back down sets of 5, and it's gonna once again be like, pretty sure like the highest volume that I've done just in terms of total workload, sets times reps times weight. So let's get to it. Okay, so we got 265 pounds on the bar for my AMRAP. But I need y'all to understand, I just did 297 pounds for 5 back down sets of 5. Once again, a volume PR. Not the heaviest I've done for back downs, just like squats. Heaviest I did for back downs on bench was last week, 314 for a 3x3. But this is even cooler, not just because of the workload thing, but the fact that I'm basically out here doing 300 pounds for a 5x5 after my top set. We're making gains. We out here cracking. Yeah, after that 5x5 with 297, pretty gassed by all we got. Alright guys, so I'm back at the crib and feeling pretty good, man. Just had a good meal, you know. Mr. Swolefessor, stay taking care of your boy when it comes to the nutritional gains. And today was like, I don't know, man, like today was just awesome. It really does just show me how well I'm progressing. Like not just block to block, but as a whole. Like I need y'all to understand something. What I hit for top sets today, not that long ago, earlier this year, those were numbers that I wouldn't be hitting until like actual like meet day, or you know, maybe 1 week out from a meet at like RPE 8 to 9. So to be hitting those at such low RPEs is just awesome. And my back down sets, man, like 407 for 5x5, that used to be a top set. 420 for a 3x4 sumo, that used to be a top set. For like just one top set. And the bench, man, bench has just been blowing up. Y'all know, out of everything, even though, like, you know, relatively speaking, you can see my bench is my best lift, that's been the one that's been hardest to add to because it's my best lift and because of where it's at. And it's just been really coming together, man. I'm really, really hyped about it. Like 297, almost 300 pounds for a 5x5. And once again, not too long ago, that was a top set. And to just compare where I was last block with pretty much the same numbers and how much better everything moved this block, just because of one, adaptations, you know, get systematically, body getting used to like the workloads, but then also like just little things like what I cued on my sumo deadlift today. Like it's just awesome to see myself progressing, like literally from week to week to week. And that's what this series is all about, guys. Like running your own race. Like y'all already know, man, I love competition. When I see the people around me getting better, it fuels me to want to keep getting better. When I see people way ahead of me, man, like when I see like my boys, Russ, Derek, even my client Michael, man, like when I see them throwing up these big numbers, for me it doesn't discourage me. It just makes me be like, yo man, if they're out here, if they can squat 600 plus pounds, there's no reason why I can't squat 500. You know what I mean? And even like being competitive with the people closer to me, like when I have people be like, hey man, I'm coming for your numbers, that lights a fire in me. But at the end of the day, my main focus, my main priority is just my own progress. Like really,
regardless of where I place, regardless of who I beat or don't beat, so long as I go into Raw Nationals in 2 weeks, go 9 for 9 and hit PRs on all three lifts, I'm good. Because, like, that's what it's all about. And I hope this carries, you know, like, I hope you guys know that this carries into not just your lifting, but life as a whole, man. Like, there's always going to be someone making more money. There's always going to be someone that it may seem like they have more of what you want. But, one, you don't know what they're dealing with behind the scenes, man. Especially with social media. Everyone just shows the highlights of their life. But, two, focus more so on where you were, where you're at, and where you're trying to go, man. Because, honestly, sometimes comparison really can be, like, the thing of joy. Like, for me, I like the comparisons, but it's because I have a healthy mindset about it. But, yeah, we out here working, man. We're 2 weeks out. Once again, just want to thank you all who support the craftsmanship shirts. At this point, like, you know, they were all sent out this past Friday. I already see a bunch of you on Instagram who've gotten them, been tagging me, and that's just really dope. It's just really cool to see you guys messing with the movement. And it's cool to see people wearing a shirt that has, like, an ideology that I came up with, kind of. You know what I mean? Or, like, in terms of, like what the message is, like, what it's really about. Like, that's just super dope. But, yeah. That's it for the video, man. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, go leave a comment down below. Let me know what you did. If you're not, leave a comment down below. Let me know what can be better. Like the video, share, subscribe. Keep it simple, specific, scientific. I'll catch you guys later.